Okay. Jake Cunningham, and in the Monroe County chapter, I'm the secretary. I'm not the chairman, secretary of the group. And what is SCOPE? SCOPE goes back to 1965, 58 years ago, when a group of concerned citizens in New York State felt like their gun ownership rights were being infringed upon. So they formed a political committee. The focus is education. SCOPE stands for Shooters Committee on Political Education. And the idea is that if you're educated, you're better informed to protect your Second Amendment rights. So they attempt to work with politicians on the state level and on the local county level and city level to educate politicians, stand up and protect Second Amendment rights at every level of government. And lastly, I think just encourage people to vote. If you think about the number of gun owners in New York State, if every gun owner voted in every election with a view to protecting our rights, our Constitution, and the Second Amendment, we would have no problems in New York. But gun owners don't vote, and that's a problem. So SCOPE tries to educate politicians, be visible in the public, stand up for our Second Amendment and all the constitutional rights, and encourage people to vote.
Doesn't it also have a publication that shows all the nasty laws the state is trying to pass, you know, from a trigger lock to now it's got to be locked in your vehicle, you know, the background checks for the ammo, the tax on the ammo, on and on, all these nasty things that tells you what's going on. Because a lot of people don't know they're breaking the law. You have to register your automatic shotgun, auto shotguns and rifles.
An automatic weapon now with the Concealed Carry Improvement Act, CCIA, that Governor Hochul passed, any automatic weapon has to be registered with the state.
Yeah. Isn't this kind of the beginning that we get a gut feeling?
Well, ultimately, I think there are those people that think gun ownership is completely unnecessary. And those forces railed against us are active nationwide. 27 states have concealed carry, New York not being one of those. But once again, if all the gun owners in New York would just go to the polls, we could control the Second Amendment infringement in the state of New York, but we don't vote. That's our problem. We don't vote.
Isn't it a contradiction that a lot of these people that don't like guns are the same people that are want the people to be let out of jail?
Oh, I think it's consistent. It's a progressive view. And SCOPE is non-political, right? We don't endorse candidates. We research candidates. We publish our research on where they stand on the Constitution, the Second Amendment. But we don't endorse anyone for political office. So we're neither Republican nor we're Democrat. We are pro-Constitution. In fact, I'm personally so fed up with all the division and infighting and name-calling currently in politics that I don't really care if I meet someone on the street. I don't care if you're a Republican, conservative, a Democrat. Doesn't matter. What matters to me is, where do you stand on the Constitution? You know, we take an oath in the military and elected office to protect and defend the Constitution against enemies foreign and domestic. But how many people really believe that? How many people would really take action upon that? I'm more concerned about where a person stands on the Constitution than their political affiliation.
So you have a publication that is...
Oh, yes, you mentioned the publication. Let's go back to that. So if you look at the charter of SCOPE, which is an educational organization, they do a couple of things very, very well, I think, at the state level. The state organization, by the way, has 20 chapters in 20 different counties in the state, 3,000 active members in the state, and Monroe County has 280 functioning members of SCOPE. The two things they do really well, one is the publication called Firing Lines, which when you join, pay your annual membership fee for SCOPE, you receive every time they publish an electronic and hard copy of Firing Lines. And Firing Lines is full of useful information about what's current, what's active, what's going on with the lawsuits, and what proposed legislation is on the docket to be considered, both pro and against Second Amendment rights. That's a great educational tool. The idea is you take that information and get hold of your state legislator to express your opinion. The other thing they do is twice, sometimes three times a week, members get an email with a short 2-minute read article about current events, something breaking in the news, and people's thoughts on that. So once you're a member of Scope, the educational aspect of it is you get both written publications and emails to keep you educated as a member. But then we have to take that education out to the public as well.
Isn't it true that these numerous lawsuits about anti-gun laws that Scope goes in with, Gun Owners of America, there's a number of organizations, that they usually win these lawsuits, but it takes sometimes take a year or two?
Oh, I think a year or two would be quick. Absolutely. Scope contributes doesn't initiate the lawsuits. We're not a large enough organization, nor do we have enough money at the state level to be the initiator of these suits, some of which cost in excess of a couple of $100,000 a year. What Scope does, however, as you've alluded to, is we contribute at the state level and at the local chapter level to other organizations who've taken the initiative, because we're all in this together. It's not really about just the Second Amendment. It's about our rights. It's about liberty. It's about freedom and the Constitution. I don't think anybody should be a one-issue voter. And you know the one-issue voters can easily get pushed and swept to one side or the other. And generally, we're just pro-Constitution, pro-freedom, pro-Second Amendment. But right there, side by side, is the First Amendment, the right to express ourselves on this. Also, the Fourth Amendment against unlawful search and seizure, because with the red flag laws, where a person can be designated as a potential threat and have their weapons seized from their home by the state police as part of the CCIA, Concealed Carry Improvement Act, the red flag laws allow them to come into your home and they'll seize your weapon, seize your ammunition, anything to do with guns, taking away your due process, violating the Fourth Amendment against unlawful search and seizure because they don't have the authority under the Constitution to do this, and then seize your weapons, and you have 7 days to go before a judge and explain why you were innocent. Because you're assumed to be guilty before you're proven innocent. We've had two people visit our Scope local chapter meeting in the last 2 months who've been the victim of red flag laws, where someone complained about them that they could be a danger. So proactively, the government comes and seizes all your weapons, all your ammunition. And I think that's ultimately going to not survive the courts.
So you have a website and you have a monthly meeting?
We have a monthly meeting, as most chapters do, but not all. Most chapters have a monthly meeting. And at that meeting, we try and inform and educate our own membership who attend. We frequently have speakers. We've had the county clerk who's responsible for registering firearms. We've had people running for political office like Challenger for the county executive position here in Monroe County. We've had several Monroe County legislators who've come and spoken with us. We've had people who look into the efficacy of our voting system in New York called New York Citizens Audit who come and spoke with us once and coming up again very soon. So we try and stay supportive of anything that deals with freedom, and always have a speaker or some information we share with the members makes it worth their attending the monthly meeting.